الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد رسول رب العالمين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا متقبلا يا رب العالمين. For Allah teach us what benefit us, increase us in knowledge, in good morals and in good deeds يا رب العالمين. So we continue, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessings in this Arabic class. And the main book we're explaining is An-Nahw Al-Wadih. And we talk about Al-Jumla, Al-Jumla Al-Mufida, a meaningful sentence. And we said it has to be, or it has to have at least two words, right? But sometimes, or sometimes apparently, it doesn't have two words. Sometimes it has one word, but the other word will be implied or hidden or not mentioned along with the other word. And we said every word in Arabic must be either ism or fa'l or harf. Kul kalima, ism or fa'l or harf. And we mentioned some points to distinguish between ism and harf, or ism and fa'l.
Right.
And then we talk about the fa'l al-madi and al-mudari' and al-fa'l al-amr. That's what we have mentioned, I think, so far. And what was the homework?
The homework was from Surah Al-Asr to Surah Al-Qasr. Change all madi to mudari.
Okay, bismillah. Yalla, who's gonna start? So from Surah Al-Asr, we said, or Al-Nasr?
No, Surah Al-Asr.
Al-Asr, okay, bismillah.
Yeah.
So every fa'al madi, we said we're gonna change every fa'al madi, which come under those four main awzan. Every fa'al madi which comes under one of those four awzan, we need to change it to the mudari.
Right.
So, as a quick reminder, we said those awzan are. Let me open the other. Here. I don't know why Zoom is not allowing me to share the whole screen. Okay, so we said those are the four awzan. Fa'ala, fa'ula, and fa'ila.
Right.
And fa'ala. Fa'ala. Fa'ula. Fa'ila. And fa'ala.
Right.
Those are the four main awzan of the madi. And those are called af'al mujarrada. Al-awzan al-fa'al al-mujarrad means these are the awzan of the fa'al al-madi that has no additional letters at all. Any fa'al madi mujarrad that doesn't have additional letters must fall under one of these four awzan. Now, is there fa'al madi? This means there are some af'al madiya that fall under other awzan, other than these. But those ones will have additional letters, right? Means you can return them to one of those four awzan. You can return them to one of those four awzan. Or you cannot return them, but they have, yani not all of their letters are original. And we said that the additional letters, or أحرف الزيادة, the letters that are usually added, or sometimes added to some verbs to give certain meanings, are سألتمونيها. They put them in this word, سألتمونيها. Where did we write that word? Here. سألتمونيها is the word that has أحرف الزيادة.
Right.
So, anyone can tell me before we go ahead how we change the madi to the mudari? What are those Awzan. What forms every wazn takes in the mudari?
Fa'ala yaf'alu, fa'ala yaf'ilu, fa'ala yaf'ulu, fa'ala
fa'ala fa'ala yaf'al yaf'ul yaf'il.
Yes.
Okay. What about fa'ila?
Fa'ila yaf'il.
Only yaf'il?
Oh, yaf'al and
yaf'al. Sorry. Yaf'al. Yaf'al and yaf'il.
Yaf'al and yaf'il. And by the way, yaf'il is rare. We said all only about 13 af'al in Arabic that has fa'ila yaf'il. Okay? Most of fa'ila is what?
Fa'ila is yaf'al.
Most of fa'ila is yaf'al. Remember this. And fa'ila yaf'il, very few words, like 13 verbs only in all of the Arabic language. And what's left?
Fa'ula yaf'ul.
Fa'ula yaf'ul. And fa'lala?
Yuf'alil.
Yuf'alil. Tamam? So these are the af'al. Fa'ala yaf'ulu yaf'alu yaf'ilu. Fa'ula yaf'ulu. Fa'ila yaf'alu yaf'ilu. Fa'lala yuf'alilu. Okay, bismillah. Let's go back to the ayat. That's, did we give anything for the homework other than this?
No.
Just that. Yalla, bismillah. Who's going to start? Yalla. You can go ahead, uncle. Wal asri inna al-insan lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr. Is there any fa'al madi here that come under
one? Amanu. Illa alladhina amanu.
Amanu. Okay.
Right. So, yu'minu.
So, what's the fa'al?
Fa'al is amana.
Amana. Is this mujarrad or mazid?
This is a mujarrad.
Mujarrad, what's the wazn?
There are like hamza and meem and noon, three letters like fa'ala, amana.
This is honestly mazid because amana is originally a'mana. A'mana, like this. And the wazn for this is not fa'ala because it's four letters, right? It's four letters.
Right.
Who knows what will the wazn be? So what is the harf ziyada here?
One of the hamza.
Exactly. Right. The first hamza. So that's why the wazn of this is af'ala. Af'ala. Why this cannot be, why amana cannot be fa'ala? Why? Remember that every haraka in the wazn must match in the word so that it fits. For example, if I say, qul, for example, qul, can I say qul is on the wazn of fa'ala? It doesn't work because the qaf has dhamma, the waw has sukun. So they have to have also the same haraka. Fa'ala, akala. I cannot say, for example, akula on the wazn of fa'ala. Also, if there's sukun, it doesn't work. If there's sukun in the verb, okay, if there is sukun in the verb, in the wazn, there has to be sukun as well. So here, let's suppose, as uncle said, amana. It's originally amana. Suppose we're going to take fa'ala. It will be fa'ala because there's an alif here, right? But anyway, you don't have to know this for now because this is not mujarrad. This is not mujarrad. So, amana, every mad in Arabic, you need to know every mad in Arabic that has hamza, a, and u, and e. This note will help you, inshallah, in knowing the origin of the af'al. E. Whenever you have a or u or e, That is maqloob or munqalib an hamza. It is originally a or u or i. And the Arabs, they replace the second hamza with a mad letter to make it easier for pronunciation. Tamam. So, for example, Adam is originally Adam. Imana, originally Imana. Utu, originally Utu. And that is, in Tajweed, what do we call it? Mad Badal. Mad Badal. Kullu Hamzin Mamdood. Every Hamza that is, that has a Mad letter. Or mad, that's followed by a Mad letter.
What's it called? Mad.
Mad. Mad al Badal.
Badal.
Two harakat is like tabi'i. Right? Adam, Utu, Imana. Tamam? This is very helpful, inshallah, for you to tell you the origin of the afal. So this is A'mana. Now, what's the origin of A'mana?
Af'ala.
Exactly. Look, here we have sukun. Where is it? A, sukun, A'mana. The wazan must be the same. Af'ala. Tamam?
Right.
A'mana af'ala. Now, what's the mudari of af'ala? Let's take this wazan. Let's add this wazan. Af'ala. What's the wazan? Yuf'ilu. Af'ala yuf'ilu. Aqdama yuqdimu. A'mana. Then a'mana will be what? What's the mudari?
Yu'minu.
Exactly. That's the mudari. Yu'minu. Yu'minu. Like this. Yuf'ilu. Tamam. Asma'a.
Yusmi'u. What's the difference between sami'a and asma'a?
Very good. Very good question. Af'ala, this form, af'ala, it has about five or more meanings. This form, the whole form. One of them, to cause something to happen.
Okay.
For example, Samiha, he heard. Asma'a, he caused someone to hear. He made someone hear. You see, Sarf is very beautiful. It will help you a lot to understand and to derive a lot of meaning. For example, Jalasa, he sat. Ajlasa, he made someone sit. For example, I say Jalastu. I sat down. Ajlastu Suhaib bijanibi. I made him sit next to me. And we will learn that in details. We will learn af'ala with all of its meaning. But this is one of them. Anyway, af'ala yuf'ilu. Right, add this to your list. Af'ala yuf'ilu. Now, where is harf al-ziyada in this wazn?
Harf ziyada, and this wasn't the first hamza.
Is the hamza?
The hamza, right? Yes. Yeah,
is the hamza? The hamza is zaida. The hamza is zaida. So af'ala yuf'ilu. Okay. Next verb. Do you want to write anything? Shall I erase?
No, that's fine.
Yeah. Next one, yalla ya Suhaib.
A'amila ya'amalu.
Where?
Illa alladhina
amalu. A'amilu. Very good. A'amila. Very good. A'amila. Even though, by the way, I yani, did not require you to know the verbs that have dhamair, but that's great. I think you should know them. So, a'amila. A'amilu. We drop this wa, which is wa wal jama'a. So, what's left for the singular? It will be a'amila. What is the wazan of amila? Amila. Fa'ila. Fa'ila. What's fa'ila? Fa'ila. Yaf'al. Yaf'il. We said most likely there are only 13 verbs. If you learn them, خلاص, you know those are the only ones. Fa'ila. Yaf'il. So this means amila. Ya. What's the wazan? What's the mudari'?
Ya'malu.
Ya'malu. Amila. Ya'malu. Amana yu'minu.
Right.
Amal. Masdar amal.
Amila ya'malu amalan. Tamam. So amila ya'malu. Tamam. Okay. Let's move on. وَيْلُ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةِ اللُّمَزَةِ
الَّذِي in the in Surah Al-Asr.
Yes.
Al-Asr. Right.
Okay, so even the mudari, you change it into madi. Okay. Let's. So, we did not cover this, but okay, we can take it. What's the... This is mudari or madi?
This is mudari.
Mudari. So what's the madi?
Wasa.
No. Tawasaw is madi.
Oh.
It's from tawasa. Take the waw of the plural. What's left? Tawasa. Yalla, who can give me the wazn for tawasa?
Oh.
If you try to guess the main letters are wasaya. Tawasa, yatawasa, from wasiya. So is the ya, the alif originally is a ya. So you're gonna take, put the fa here. See how you get to know the wazn. The main letters are the waw and the sad and the ya. Put the fa here and the ayn here and the lam here. Okay? Because this is wasaya fa'ala. Now add huruf ziyada. Huruf ziyada are what? Here. The ta, put the ta. The alif with the alif. So what's now the wazn?
Tafa'ala.
Tamam? Tafa'ala. 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 This is a very nice wazn, by the way. It gives you a lot of meanings and it solves a lot of problems. Tafa'ala. Is a form or wazn that indicates interaction from the two sides. Two sides or two parties doing the action and interacting. Tamam? Tafa'ala. Tawasa. Tafa'ala. Tawasa. From awsa, not awsa, awsa. وَصَيَ فَعَلَ أَوْصَى أَفْعَلَ. No, it is not تَوَأَوْصَى, it is تَوَاصَى. Like two people, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَوَاصَوا بِالْحَقِّ. They recommend one another. They advise each other. They recommend one another. They remind one another of the truth and of patience. That's تَوَاصِي. تَوَاصِي. Interaction. تَفَاعُل. تَفَاعُل means interaction. تمام؟ So that's the meaning of this wazn. What's the mudari? Always for the mudari, you're going to put aya with a dhamma for the third person masculine. So it will become what?
Yatafa'alu.
Tafa'ala. Yatafa'alu. Yatafa'alu. Tafa'ala. Yatafa'alu. Yalla.
Yatawasa.
Tafa'ala. Yatafa'alu. So tawasa. Yatawasa. تواصوا يتواصون تمام So now we have two new أوزان we learned أفعل يفعل تفاعل يتفاعل تواصى يتواصى تقاتل يتقاتل تقاتلا, they fought one another. تقاتلا. There's another form which is close, which is قاتلا, فاعلا. فاعل يفاعل. قاتل يقاتل. شارك يشارك. تشارك. So they might consider this as فاعلا and the ta is also additional. تفاعل تواصل Okay, so what's left? That's Surat Al-Asr. Nothing left in Surat Al-Asr. Now, الهمزة. What's the first word that comes? It's very clear.
جمع.
جمع. فعل. What's the wazn? فعل. جمع. يفعل. يفعل. يجمع. could be yaf'ul yajma', could be yaf'il yajma', could be one of these three, right? How do I know? I have to memorize it, right? I have to memorize it. Just as we memorize the English irregular verbs like go, went, gone, drive, drove, driven, coast, cast, right? Then we have to learn those. Jama'a yajma'u.
Yajma'u.
Jama'a yajma'u. Fa'ala yaf'al.
What's the meaning of jama'a?
Jama'a gathered. Jama'a ma'lan gathered, collected, accumulated.
No, what's the mustar? Jama'a yajma'u.
Jama'an.
Jama'an.
يلا يحسب أن ماله
and there is another verb in this ayah وعدده
عدده right exactly so عدده take the who what's left عدده now is there an ziyada letter in this fa'al? Is yeah, there any of the letters of sa'altumuniha? No.
No, sorry.
No, right?
Yeah.
So this wasn, mudha'af, addada, mudha'af means mushaddad, means it has shadda. What will that wasn't be?
Fa'ala.
Fa'ala. When there is tad'if, so we added a letter. So this is a point I didn't mention to you, and it will come when we talk about in details about tajreed and ziyada. Is, we can add it here. A ziyada addition. الزيادة وقد تكون الزيادة بتضعيف حرف أصلي مد or عدد جمع so you should ask me that I said the awzan of the madi that are mujarrad are only fa'ala, fa'ula, fa'ila, fa'lala. And this is addada. It doesn't have ziyada letters. And it's not one of those four awzan. Right?
Yeah. So what is it? Is it ziyada? Is it mazid?
Or, first of all, ziyada, in addition to the ziyada letters, okay, in addition to the ziyada letters, could be with multiplying or tashdeed of one of the original letters. Okay?
Okay.
One more time. Ziyada could be by adding one of sa'atumuniha letters, and also could be by making tashdeed for one of the original letters. Okay. Yalla, what's the next fa'al?
Hasiba yahsabu.
Yahsabu. Very good. Yahsabu means yadhunnu, he thinks. Yahsabu anna ma lahu akhladahu. Yahsabu, he thinks. يحسب it's on the wazn of يفعل right يحسب يفعل now يفعل this is مضارع يحسب يفعل مضارع يفعل is the مضارع of what ماضي remember فعل يفعل sorry it's not for فعل فعل يفعل أن يفعل so could be for فعل so could be what the ماضي could be what
It could be
حسب
حسبة. So that, right. let's say that's one possibility. Mm-hmm. Is there another possibility? Yes. حسب. Right? Because فعل could be يفعل. يفعل. But this فعل, if you say حسب from حساب.
Right.
Calculated. حسب يحسب. حسب يحسب. حساباً. That's calculation.
Right.
حسب. حسب يحسب. حسب يحسب. Which means he thought.
Hmm.
And يحسب, he thinks. So حسب يحسب. And in one of the قراءات, it's يحسب. So it also works حسب يحسب. But just for now, to not to get confused, just the verb is حسب in the ماضي. حسب. And if you say حسب, you change the meaning.
Right.
حسابا is the مصدر.
Yeah, but here, no, حسب. 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 يحسب. حسب. يحسب. Not حساب, no. حسبان.
حسبان.
Yeah, حسب يحسب حسبانا not حسابا حسبانا.
He thought.
And maybe حسبا also. So حسب we have يحسب. So, as you see here, Imam Ibn Manzoor,
right.
What does he say? He says, حسب الشيء يحسبه ويحسبه حسبانا حسب حسبانا not حسابا حسب حسبان. I said حسبان, that's not right. حسبان. Okay, حسبان. ومحسبة ومحسبة. ظنه, he thought. وإنما هو نادر عندي على من قال يحسب ففتح. وأما على من قال يحسب فكسر فليس بنادر. وفسحة وفسحة. وإذا قال أحسبه بالكسر. وهو شاذ. So, حسب, as I told you, it could be يحسب and يحسب. And in the Quran, we have two of the قراءات. Some قراءات يحسب, some قراءات يحسب. Because some are said this way, some are said this way. Now look what Imam Ibn Manzoor is saying. وهو شاذ لأن he's saying كل فعل كان ماضيه مكسورا. Every فعل whose ماضي is مكسور, which means فعلة. فإن مستقبله يأتي مفتوح العين. Then the future will be with فتحة of the عين. So he's saying what? He's saying فعل يفعل. You hear what he's saying? He's saying every ماضي that is on the form of on the وزن of فعل. What should be the مستقبل or the مضارع?
يفعل يفعل.
مفتوح العين مفتوح العين. What's the عين? The عين of the فعل. يفعل. مفتوح العين. He's telling you فعل should be يفعل. He's telling you فعل should be يفعل. But we learned فعل should be what? Could be what?
يفعل يفعل.
Could be يفعل or?
يفعل.
يفعل. Let's see what he did not finish. Then he's saying نحو علم يعلم. علم يعلم. شرب يشرب. تمام؟ سمع يسمع. These are most of the verse. Look what he says there. إلا أربعة أحرف جاءت نوادر. He's saying, except for four أحرف جاءت نوادر. Four letters that came that are rare. Hasiba is one of them. Yahsib, according to that dialect of the Arabs. Hasiba, Yahsib. Yabisa, Yaybis. Yaisa, Yayis.
Yaybis.
Yan'im. These have two dialects, because Yaisa also Yayas. And Yabisa, Yaybas. And Na'ima, Yan'am. فإنها جاءت من السالم بالكسر والفتح. Look what he's saying. كسر and فتح. This is a little bit advanced, but you can write them down because these أفعال are the only ones. So he's saying, فإنها جاءت من السالم. What does he mean? سالم means حرف فعل مجرد, no additional letters, no زيادة letters, and no علة letters. That's سالم. And no tashdeed. That is sari. We're going to learn those types of af'al and names. Also, the mujarrad has names. The mujarrad could have a illa letter, means alif or wa or ya, could have a shadda, could have a hamza. So we have salim, we have muda'af, we have mahmuz, etc. So the scholars, they gave them names so that they can derive for us rules for all of those verbs or af'al. So these four af'al, what's the mudari' for them?
Fa'ila yaf'ilu.
No, he said kasr and fatah.
Oh, fa'ila yaf'alu, and it's yaf'alu and yaf'il.
Yaf'al and yaf'il. He's telling you these could be with both. Fa'ila yaf'al and fa'ila yaf'il. Hasiba yahsab and yahsib. This makes you understand also the qira'at. When you hear someone reading يَحْسِبُ أَنَّ مَعْلَوْ أَخْلَدَ, you know that is another qira'ah, another way. يَيْبَسْ, يَيْبِسْ, يَنْعَمْ, يَنْعِمْ, etc. Now, he says وَمِنَ الْمُعْتَلِّ مَا جَاءَ مَاضِيهِ وَمُسْتَقْبَلَهُ جَمِيعًا بِالْكَسْرِ. And there are af'al مُجَرَّدَ, means they don't have ziyada letters, but they are mu'tal. What does that mean? They have illa letters. They have waw or ya or alif in them. And the alif will go back to waw or ya. So they have ya or waw. Those af'al, only with kasr. And those are the rare ones that I told you. There are only 13 verbs or af'al in Arabic. And he's mentioning them. Or maybe some of them. He's saying, wamiqa yamiqu. And there is hadith here because it's originally yawmiqu, it becomes yamiqu. Wafiqa, 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 yafiqu. Wari'a, yari'u. Warima, yarimu. Waritha, yarifu. Wawariya, azzandu, yari. Wawaliya, yali. Tamam? So how many are those? Wahid, nain, laati, arba, khamis, six, eight. So all of these are 12 all together. واحد اثنين ثلاثة أربعة خمسة ستة سبعة ثمانية تسعة عشر. Okay, then he says يحسب أن ما له أخلده. You see the eye we're just reading. أخلده أي يخلده. مثله نادى أصحاب النار أي ينادي. Okay. Okay. You guys got it?
Yeah.
12 أفعال he mentioned. We can put them here. This is a very beneficial point for us in the Awzan. Okay, we can add it there to the table so that we know was af'al or awzan. Fabiola, what's after yahsib? Yahsabu anna alahu akhlada, then what? Yes.
Akhlada is also a verb, right?
Akhladahu, exactly. Akhladahu. Akhladahu. Yes. Akhladahu, we mentioned this today, right? Akhladahu, take the who, what's left?
Akhlada.
Akhlada. What's the wazn?
Af'ala.
Af'ala, yuf'ilu. Akhlada, yukhlidu.
Yukhlidu.
Exactly. Akhladahu, yukhliduhu. And by the way, the meaning here in this ayah is yukhliduhu, not akhladahu.
Right.
But that's how the Arabs speak. So he thinks his wealth will immortalize him. Is that the verb? Immortalize him? Will make him live forever.
Yeah, immortalize, yeah.
So see how the Arabs, they phrase it here. They use Madi, but they mean the Mubari. Because he doesn't think that his wealth made him immortal. He thinks that his wealth makes him immortal. And that's why Ibn Manzur in the same topic there, he said, Akhladahu means yukhliduhu.
So that comes from the word khalada.
Khalada, yeah.
Khalada
yakhlidu? Khalada yakhludu, I think. Yakhlud, khulud. So, akhlada yukhlidu, af'ala yuf'ilu. So, we took af'ala today, right? A'mana, a'mana, af'ala. So, we took, as you can see, af'ala now, two, we have two. Af'ala yuf'ilu. And here you see, akhlada means his wealth caused him to live forever, he thinks. So af'ala, so you see this form af'ala to cause something to happen or to cause someone to do something. So af'ala yuf'ilu, and we took also what? Tafa'ala yatafa'al, right? Okay, kalla la yunbadanna fil hutama. Yunbad, this is passive voice. When it's a little bit advanced for now. Wama adraka min hutama narullahi munqada allati tattali'u. اطلع اطلع يطلع. Did you do that? تطلع.
No.
It's like
is أدراك أيام فعل as well.
أدراك. Yeah, yeah, yeah. أدراك.
So ينبذلنا is also فعل, right?
ينبذلنا is فعل also, but it's passive voice, so it's a little bit advanced, but we can work on it if you like. So ينبذلنا is مضارع, right? ينبذلنا مضارع. It's called مبني للمجهول or لم يسمى فاعله. لا ينبذن. He will be thrown out to الحطمة. So from نبذ. نبذ. نبذ.
نبذ. Oh.
ينبذ.
نبذ.
ينبذ. ينبذ. He will be thrown out. ينبذ.
So nabada is he.
No, the Madi for this nubida. Passive voice. Nubida. Yumbadu. That's we learned this the last fa'al, maybe we'll learn it because it's passive voice, a passive form. Means the fa'al is not mentioned. So it comes always with dhamm in the beginning. In what? The Madi and in Mudari. Nubida yumbadu. Ukila yu'kalu. For example, ukila means it was eaten. Yu'kalu, it is eaten. Tamam? So we will learn this later. But for if you want the answer, this is how it is. Nubidha yumbadu. That's the Madi.
Nubidha.
Nubidha.
Tamam? Nubidha yumbadu.
So what is the noon here? Yumbazanna.
This is noon of the emphasis. Noon al-tawkid.
Noon al-tawkid, right.
What's the mudari' of nabada? Is it nabada yambidu?
Nabada yambudu.
Yambudu nibada.
Yambuduhu yatrahuhu.
What's the mustar?
Nabada yambudu nabzan.
Nabzan.
Okay, mashallah. So you worked on every single fa'al. Okay, that's good.
Yeah. So here we have two emphatic, so like lam is also nam
taqeel, right? Exactly, that's lam al qasam, yeah. Lam al muwatti al qasam. Yes. So originally the madi is nubida, passive voice. Right. The active and normal madi is nabada, nabada, nubida. Okay. What else? Adraka, adra. Adraka from adra. A'mana, adra. Daraya, adra. It's originally from I think daraya. So it will be af'ala. Adra, adra, af'ala. Adra yudri. Adrani yudrini. So the ya, the alif is originally a ya, so it will be adra, adraya. Af'ala yudri, yuf'il. Tamam?
Yeah.
Adraka, take the kaf. So adra, af'ala. So as you can see, adra, the alif is sakina. So how am I saying af'ala? It should be, someone might say, it should be af'a. Say no. The fa'al must have fa'ain lam. Where is the lam of the fa'al? It's the alif. But the alif is sakina. We say the alif always, always, its origin is either a waw or a ya. You remember that? I mentioned this last time. And how do you know? Bring it to the mubari' or the masdar. You will know. Adra yudri. See, what's the original of the alif? Is a ya. So adra ya. Af'ala. Tamam? Yuf'ilu yudri. Wama yudrika. In the Quran it came. Wama yudrika. Adraka yudrika. Af'alaka yuf'iluka. Af'ala yuf'ilu. Tamam? So again, we have three verbs so far. Af'ala. Adra, akhlada, af'ala. So we took two forms only so far, the new ones, right? Af'ala, fa'ala.
Fa'ala.
Huh?
And fa'ala, like fa'ala, you know. Fa'ala.
Fa'ala, we already learned it. I'm saying the new ones, af'ala and tafa'ala, right?
What's the meaning of that? What's adri? Meaning?
Wama adra, adra, who told you? ما أدراك, who told you? Or what told you?
So أدرى means who told you?
No, أدرى told.
Oh, okay.
ما أدراك, who told you? Or what told you? تمام؟ يلا, أر الله الموقدة.
So, Sheikh, أدري is also like... no, like la adri.
Yeah, exactly. Adri, af'al.
Yeah.
Adri, af'al.
So when the angels will ask the questions in the grave, so the person who does not know, he will be saying la adri.
Exactly, la adri. I don't know.
Right.
So la adri from daraya fa'ala.
Daraya.
Yadri yaf'al. Here af'ala. Adra. You see, adri, I know. Adra, he told. He caused someone to know. Again, you see this af'al? You see this? The form af'ala, tamam, af'ala, to cause someone to do something. That's one of the main meanings that we have seen. Akhlada, to cause him to immortalize, to make him immortalized. Adra, to make him know, to told him, to tell him, right? So we learned af'ala, yuf'ilu. And let's see here, write the meaning, to cause someone to do something or to make him do something. This is the wazn. The wazn of af'ala yuf'ilu. Okay, and we also learned what? Tafa'ala yatafa'alu. Interaction. That's it. These are the two awzan we learned, the new awzan, right? You're not required to know them, but now you are. Yalla, what's after that?
Nothing, I don't think. In this
surah. Nothing in Surah Al-Humazah. Okay.
Alam tara kayfa.
Tab yalla, let's do the feel. Yalla, what's the first fi'l we have?
Tara. Alam tara. Tara.
Alam tara. Yeah, this is, yani, it has illa letter. Tara. What's this is mudari or madi?
Madi.
This is mudari.
Mudari. One of the ways you can know for sure it's mudari is after lam. Okay. These notes are extremely important. You don't find them like compiled in one book. So make sure write them down. To know like how I know this is mudari. How this is one of the important tips. Lam, you will never have lam ja'a, lam ra'a, lam. Okay, after lam, there must be mudari. After lam, there must be mudari. Also, you know it's a fa'al, by the way. So you know if there must be a fa'al after lam, and there must be, and that fa'al must be mudari. You will never hear lam al-kitab, lam Ahmad, lam, never. So after lam, there must be mudari, and there must be what? There must be fa'al, and it must be mudari. So you can add it to the list about the things that help you distinguish between ism and fa'al. So I myself didn't read them in one book, but whenever we have a sign that I'm sure that doesesn't have like an exception or it's clear cut, I add it myself also to the list. So we add Bismillah. So بعد لم لا بد أن يكون فعلا مضارعا. Okay. Yeah.
Sheikh, what does la buddha mean? I heard this in lot of khutub.
La buddha, it must be.
It must, okay.
If you say la buddha and af'al, I must do that. Okay. I must do it. La buddha means no. Literally, it means like no escape of doing that. Literally.
And the other word I was not sure. Yambagi.
Yambagi ought to. Like should.
Should.
Yambagi.
Okay.
Yambagi an nata'allam. We should learn. Okay, look what Imam Ibn Manzur says about the fa'al ittala'a. He's saying about one of the verb words here. He says, وَلَكِنَّهُ شَبَّهَ تَاءَ خَبَطْ 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 وَخَبَطْتَ بِتَاء إِفْتَعَلَ فَقَلَبَهَا طَاءً لِوَقُوعِ الطَّاءِ قَبْلَهَا كَقَوْلِهِ اطلع اطلع خضبت بتاء افتعل فقلبها طاء. As I told you, and the ta is turned, is originally ta. But the Arabs, to make it easy, they say it this way. And they make it another ta, and they merge them. They merge them. Okay. What's after that? So alam tara from yara. Alam tara. Tara is mudari'. What's the madi? Tara anta. Ra'aita.
Ra'a.
Ra'aita tara. Ra'a yara. We will learn that because it has a عِلَّ letter, so it will be a little bit advanced for you. But if you want the مُضَارِع, this is مُضَارِع. تَرَى. تَرَى أَنْتَ. Originally تَرَى. We drop the alif because of لَمْ. لَمْ will make us drop the عِلَّ letter, okay? In the مُضَارِع. We will learn that also later, inshallah. So what's the ماضي?
رَأَى.
The ماضي here, رَأَيْتَ. رَأَيْتَ أَنْتَ. تَرَى أَنْتَ. تمام؟ رأى يرى تمام رأى يرى
مست مصدر
ترى رأى يرى رؤيا ورأيا ورئيا رأى يرى يرى يا اوكي ألم ترى كيف فعل فعل يفعل right فعل يفعل فعل يفعل so فعل this is not a wazn this is the فعل right it means to do what else
ألم يجعل جعل يجعل
تمام جعل يجعل ألم يجعل كيدهم يجعل جعل يجعل like فعل يفعل Okay, alam yaj'al kaydahum fi tadlil wa arsala. Arsala.
Yursilu.
Aywa, what's the wazn? We took it today.
Yuf'ilu.
Af'ala yuf'ilu. See, arsala, he sent. He sent. Right? He caused him to go, right? He sent him. So you see, af'ala until now, it's always. Or this is the meaning that we have seen so far, to cause something or someone to do something or to happen. Okay, what else?
Tarmi.
From Ramaya. From Ramaya. What's the wazn? Ramaya. Fa'ala. Ra-ma-ya, fa-a-la, right?
Mm.
Ra-ma-ya, fa-a-la. What's the wazn?
Fa-a-la, yaf'alu?
Yarmi.
Oh, fa-a-la, yaf'alu.
Fa-a-la, yaf'alu. Yaf'alu, yarmi. Tamam?
What does that mean? Ra-ma-ya, yarmi.
To throw.
Oh, okay.
To throw.
What's the master?
Rama Yarmi Ramyan. Ra'a Yara Ru'yatan. And maybe Ri'yan. Okay.
So
here Madi should be Rami, right?
Ramaya. The Madi is Ramaya. That's the Madi. So do you see the Mus'haf on the screen? Okay, so we're done with Ramaya. we're done with tarmim. فجعلهم جعل فجعلهم. So take the fa, take the lam, the ha and the lam. So what's left? جعل. What's the مضارع?
يجعل.
يجعل. You see, because we need to memorize some of them. Okay, so for me, I didn't memorize them. I have to memorize some of them because some of them we don't use them, so I have to memorize them. The one we use them, I know جعل يجعل. I know it must be يجعل. جعل يجعل فعل يفعل. It doesn't work يجعل or يجعل. So we're done with this surah. We'll stop here, inshallah. So what do you have left? Quraysh, Ma'un, and Kawthar. Okay. Okay, so you're doing every single fa'al, which is nice. Okay, even though you don't have to do that, but I think that is very beneficial, inshallah. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Any question about anything? Sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in, walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. So we took two more awzan and a lot of benefits. I hope you write them down, and inshallah you add to what you got. We continue next time, inshallah.
بارك الله فيك.